A new study published in the journal Nature Climate Change says that even if we stopped emitting greenhouse gases immediately, right now, no more emissions, effective immediately, Greenland would still lose 3.3% of their ice sheet, which would result in a 12-inch, 1-foot sea level rise across the planet. We have hit the point of climate change that even if all emissions were to cease to exist right now, we're still headed for catastrophe. That is what this new report tells us. And the worst part about that is that's the optimistic part of it, right? They still carry that message that do not despair, we can do something, we can actually stop even worse things from happening. But this 1 foot sea level rise at this point, you know, based on my reading of this, does appear inevitable. And that's a terrifying thought. And it's something that, of course, everybody's been warned about many times for several decades now. And we as a country only just recently passed our very first piece of, I guess, climate legislation ever. Ever, folks. That's how bad we have been as a country. You know, that's not even including, I know, but other countries are bigger polluters. I get it. I'm not a moron, okay? One other country is a bigger polluter, and that's China. We're number two. And then I think it's India. And we could go down and down and down and down that list, but that's not important. We should be the leaders on this issue, and we're not. And the reason we're not is because every couple years, we end up with a doofus in the White House, typically with an R next to their name, that pretends that climate change doesn't exist, or that tells us that climate change is a Chinese hoax, or is too dumb to understand what science is telling them. We have Republican politicians who, when asked about climate change, say, no, it's not real, but I'm not a scientist, man. And this is what we get. We're going to get a foot of sea level rise by the year 2050. So we got 28 years. And a foot of sea level rise, by the way, just so everybody understands, because I know there's a lot of people who don't quite understand this, like, oh, that means the water comes, you know, closer to shore by 1 foot. No. A sea level rise of 1 foot. And then that 1 foot extends all the way out until it hits the shore again, right? As the shore curves down, up, they meet. So a 1 foot sea level rise is about an 8 to 10 foot encroachment of water. That's how that works, depending on the way the shoreline is sloped. So it's a significant problem. But again, we could be working on this. We could be doing something about it. Because if we do not, and again, that 3.3% melt of Greenland's ice sheet is only if we stopped all the emissions right now. It gets so much worse when you look at it. If Greenland's ice sheet were to disintegrate completely, sea levels would rise more than 22 feet, enough to double the frequency of storm surge flooding in many of the world's largest coastal cities by the end of the century. So the stakes for adequate climate action are still immense, even if a certain amount of melting has been deemed irreversible, which is the situation we're in right now. You know, I talked in another story about the fact that the state of Mississippi, 180,000 people in the capital of Jackson, Mississippi, without water because the recent flooding, you know, climate-related events damaged their water system so badly they can't pump water. That's climate change. Texas, their energy grid failures, that's climate change. Lake Mead drying up. The Hoover Dam may not even have enough water to produce electricity in a couple years, folks. That's climate change. The wildfires in California, the wildfires in Colorado, the winter storms up north, folks. All of this is climate change. And we're sitting here watching it get worse. We're sitting here watching these scientists give us warning after warning after warning. And what are we doing? We're tuning it out. We're pretending it's not real. Oh, it's a far-off threat. We don't have to worry about it. as I always say, it's not knocking on our door. It has already burst through the door. It is in our living room. It's obstructing our view of the TV, and we're still just trying to, oh, I don't want to see it. I'm trying to look around it. It's here. And we're already seeing the bad things, but these bad things are nothing compared to what could be coming down the pipeline if we do not take action. 150 million people are expected to be displaced by the year 2050 on current projections. 150 million. And you've seen how Republicans freak out when you have a couple hundred people try to cross the border. Imagine a couple million. Maybe then they'll start taking it seriously. I know what a lot of you out there are thinking. You're thinking, wouldn't it be amazing if you could wear the Ring of Fire logo across your chest? Well, now you can. Just head on over to our Teespring page to find some awesome merch we're offering for our viewers. We have more designs that are going to be added in the near future, so just follow the link in the description or take a peek at the shelf of merchandise under this video. Thanks for watching.